will begin the bidding. We have an iconic auction house on the block today. 275 years old, the world's oldest, largest, Sotheby's biggest sale ever. Itself. Yes, the winning bid, $3.7 billion. The producers are going to rue the day they gave me this. This is from the gentleman in black over there, billionaire art collector and telecoms entrepreneur, Patrick Drahi. And with our sale today, we mark the end of Sotheby's three decades, count them, three, as a public company. Apparently, Matt, Ian, it could not happen soon enough for Sotheby's. Patrick Drahi, this is so interesting. He paid a 60% premium for this company. What does he know that the rest of us are missing in this market?
That's right. You know, I think rather than this being an acquisition of what it is like an undervalued property, which is like what you normally think about in a go private deal, this is really a trophy asset that Patrick Drahi is buying. If you look at what he said that this is something that he wants him and his family to own for many years to come. The CEO of Sotheby's talked about how he thinks that Patrick Drahi is going to own this for decades. Drahi said that he's not going to make any changes to the management or to the company's strategy. So this is not a type of situation where we think that this is gonna get flipped over in a couple of years, they're gonna add on, you know, they're gonna cut costs or anything like that. This seems more like a legacy play for Patrick Drahi.
That's such a good way to put it, right? That trophy asset. And from Sotheby's reaction, you kind of got the sense that, thank goodness, finally we're out of this public market, right?
That's right. I mean, the stock is up almost 60%. And, you know, we saw the company say that the reason why they want to go private is because this will give them the flexibility to accelerate their turnaround plan. And in other words, they just want to kind of get away from the harsh scrutiny of the Wall Street analysts and journalists and the shareholders. And so they think that their life, their long-term success will be better as a private company.
It's interesting, and I'm sure a lot of our viewers have heard a lot about the art market in the last little while. I mean, even people like David Bowie, who you would never think of, had a prolific art collection, and I hate to tell you, made tons of money on it over the years. Is this saying something more, though, about art as an investment as we go through the decades?
I think it might be. I mean, if you look at how much the value on some of these pieces of art have increased in just a short amount of time, it really is pretty stunning. In some ways, it is a reflection of this low and zero and even negative interest rate environment where people are forced to kind of go out on the risk spectrum in order to get returns. And Patrick Drahi is figuring, rather than just going out and buying another piece of art, I'm going to just go acquire an art house itself.
Yeah, it might be a very good move. You want to do the gavel the last time? The producers will never let me have it again. It's only because, you know, Richard won't. They felt sorry for me because Richard won't let me touch the bell. So there you go. Matt, thanks so much. Really
Thank
fascinating
you.
Story.